Hello, my name is S. N. Patil. In a previous video lecture, we discussed the basic of number system. In this video lecture, we will discuss quadratic equation and relation between coefficient and roots. Here we have taken the standard equation of quadratic ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. This is 2-degree polynomial, obviously it has a 2 roots. Here we define the roots by the formula alpha is equal to minus b plus under root b square minus 4ac upon twice a. The second root is denoted by beta and defined as minus b minus under root b square minus 4ac divided by twice a. Let us find the relation between roots and their coefficient. So first of all, we must have the monic polynomial. For that, we identify the highest degree coefficient of highest degree. Here, the highest power of variable is 2 and its coefficient is a. So first of all, divide throughout a. Then we get simplified form x square plus b upon a into x plus c upon a. Then the addition of the roots is alpha plus beta is equal to minus b upon a, and the product of the root is c upon a. For example, x square minus 3x plus 2 is equal to 0. When we find the roots, we get alpha is equal to 2 and beta is equal to 1. Then its addition is 2 plus 1 is 3. Okay, so addition is minus time second coefficient. So here the second coefficient is b upon a. Okay, and the product is 2 into 1, that is the constant term. The constant term is 2, that is the in standard form, the constant term is c upon a. Let us discuss the nature of the roots. If b square minus 4ac is equal to 0, then it has a repeated root. If b square minus 4ac is strictly greater than 0, then it has a real and distinct root. And if b square minus 4ac is negative, strictly less than 0, then it has imaginary roots. Okay, so these are the nature of the roots. Okay, let us make it generalize. See, here I am consider nth degree polynomial having coefficient a naught a1 up to an. The constant term is n, an. The first of all, we divide throughout a naught. Then we get the simplified form is x raised to n plus a1 upon a naught into x raised to n minus 1 plus a2 upon a naught into x raised to n minus 2 plus dot 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 plus a suffix n minus 1 divided by a naught into x plus an upon a naught is equal to 0. Now, the relation of roots and their coefficient is the addition of the odd roots. See, this is the nth degree polynomial. It has a n roots, alpha 1, alpha 2, up to alpha n. When we take the addition is always minus times the second coefficient. What is the second coefficient here? A1 upon a naught, and which is minus time. Now the second, actually, I have considered the first coefficient is 1, second coefficient is a1 upon a0, third coefficient is a2 upon a0. Then relation of third coefficient is product of two roots and its addition is second coefficient. Third coefficient. Similarly for fourth, product of three roots is minus time fourth coefficient. In this way, plus minus plus minus, and last, product of all roots is equal to minus 1 raised to n an suffix a naught. Means if there is a odd degree polynomial, then product of the roots is minus time constant term, and if the even degree polynomial, then product of the roots is always constant term. There is no change of the sign. For example, I have just taken the example x square minus 3x plus 2. the plus 2 is a product of the roots. If we consider x cube minus 3x square plus 3x minus 1, here the product of the roots, is a 1, but the in a polynomial there is a minus 1. Okay, that is a minus 1 coefficient. Okay, binomial theorem a plus b raised to n is equal to nc0 a raised to n b raised to 0 plus nc1 a raised to n minus 1 b raised to 1 plus dot 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 plus ncn a raised to n minus 1 b raised to n, where ncr is n factorial divided by n minus r factorial into r factorial, and this is the the last thing is simplified form, the last equation where we simplified the nc0, nc0 is 1, nc1 is n, and so on. Okay, thank you.